Factory is proud to present Rocky Horror Live.
Way. You be a girl.
a strange journey. It seemed a fairly ordinary night when Brad Majors and his fiancée, Janet Weiss,
what?
Two young, ordinary, healthy kids, left Denton that late November evening to visit a Dr. Everett Scott, ex-tutor and now friend to both of them. It's true, there were dark storm clouds, heavy, black, and pendulous, towards which they were driving. It's true also that the spare tire they were carrying was badly in need of some air. But they being normal kids, and well, on a night out, they nothing but storms for the events of the evening. On a night out. It was a night out they were going to remember for a very long time.
I think we took the wrong fork a few miles back. Maybe we should head on up the road and see if we can find our way back.
What's that thing?
Doc, I think we have a blown front left-hand tire. You better stay here and keep warm while I go for help.
Oh, where will you go? We're in the middle of nowhere.
Didn't we pass a castle a few miles back? Maybe they have a phone I can use.
I'm coming with you.
There's no point in both of us getting wet.
I'm coming with you. Besides, Brad, darling, the owner of that phone might be a beautiful young woman, and you may never come back to me.
Thank you.
house. Our car broke down on the road, and we were wondering if you might have a telephone number.
You're wet.
Oh, yes, it's raining.
Yeah, I think we both perhaps better come by.
You are too kind.
And so it seems that fortune had smiled on Brad and Janet, and that they found the assistance that their plight required. Or had it. There was certainly something about this house to which a flat tire and a wet mat had brought them that made them both feel uneasy. That if they were to reach their destination that night, they would have to ignore such feelings and take advantage of whatever help was offered.
Brad, I'm cold and I'm frightened.
It's all right, kid. It's probably just some hunting lodge for rich weirdos.
You've arrived on a rather special night. It's one of the master's affairs.
Lucky him.
Yeah, he's lucky. You're lucky, I'm lucky, we're all lucky! The delivery boy.
The master's delivery wasn't good enough.
The master only wanted to help the boy better his position.
That's very commendable.
Yes, it seems like yesterday before he went.
To pieces.
Wait!
To pieces. It's time, baby.
Oh! get out of here. It seems so unhappy here.
Well, we can't go anywhere until I can get the telephone.
This isn't the Junior Chamber of Commerce, Brad.
Well, they're probably foreigners with different ways from our own. They might do some more folk dancing.
Look, I'm tired, I'm wet, and I'm just getting scared.
I'm here, Janet. There's nothing to worry about.
Yeah. you less. It's not too often we receive visitors here, let alone offer them hospitality.
Hospitality? All we wanted to do was use your phone. A reasonable request, goddammit, which you have chosen to ignore.
Don't be ungrateful, Brad.
Ungrateful?
Forcefully you are, Brad. Such a fine specimen of lead, but so dominant. You must be very proud, Janet.
Yes, I am.
Tell me, Brad. Do you have any tattoos? Well,
certainly not.
Oh, well.
How about you?
Everything is in readiness, Master. We merely await your word.
Tonight, my unconventional conventionists, you are to witness a new breakthrough in biochemical research. And paradise is to be mine! It is strange how it happened. Suddenly, you get a break. And then, all the pieces seem to fit. Oh, a sucker, I've been what a fool! The answer was there all the time. It took but a small accident to make it happen. An accident! And that is how I discovered that elusive ray, that spark, that is the breath of life. Yes, I had knowledge. I pulled the key to life itself! And throw open the switches to the sonic oscillator. And step up the reactor power output. 3 more.
Thank you.
lucky. That's no way to behave on your first day out. But since you're such an exceptional beauty, I'm prepared to forgive you. Well, he's a credit to your genius, man.
He's a triumph.
I know.
Just 7 days.
and reality as we know it is merely a figment of the imagination. If this is so, Brad and Janet are quite safe. But there are some who have a far more physical philosophy. Those who would stop at nothing to satisfy their base desires. However, the sudden departure of their host and his creation into the seclusion of their somber bridal suite had left them feeling both apprehensive and uneasy. A feeling which grew as the other guests departed and they were shown to their separate rooms. It would seem that after experiencing his wedding night bliss with Rocky, Frank was still not by himself. Later that evening in the castle, dressed as Brad, Frank seduced Janet. But that wasn't enough. Dressed as Janet, Frank then seduced Brad. It was clear that they all had been if one is suffering from the pangs of remorse for a sexual indiscretion, it would seem logical that the transgressor would be sympathetic toward the loved one caught committing a similar misdemeanor. But emotion is an irrational and powerful master. And from what Columbia and Magenta were about to witness, there was little doubt that Janet was indeed its slave.
Tell us about it. Little only in the east, not alone.
know this earthling? I mean, person?
I certainly do. He's a friend of mine.
So, this was an intense meeting after all, was it? Brad, you came here with a purpose.
Well, that's not true. My car broke down. I told you.
I know what you told me. But this Dr. Everett's got his name. It's not unknown to me.
Well, he's a science teacher at Dick High.
Right, and now he works in a gang that man. Doesn't he, Brad? He's attached to the Bureau of the Investigation of that which you call you as oath. Am I wrong, Brad?
He might be, I don't know.
The intruder is entering the building, Master.
Ah, he's an attendant.
Riffraff, seal up all the exits except the ones that lead here. Gather everyone. I think it's time we make this a social occasion.
Dr. Von Scott!
What is that in your
hand? This machine here!
What do you think it does, Doc?
At this precise moment, it's hard to tell, but it seems to be made of a metal not from this earth, that I would say, though, it is from another planet!
Programming and secure all levels.
and then you spit them out again. Well, I love you, do you hear? I love you, and what did I get? Well, I'll tell you, a big, fat nothing! They're like a spot you tank and drain others of their affection. Well, I've had it, and I mean I am out of here now.
Their engagement, Brad and Janet had both tasted forbidden fruit. This in itself was proof that their host was a man of little morals and some persuasion. What further indignities were they to be subjected to? And what of the sonic transducer and the floor show that had been spoken of? What indeed? From what had gone before, it was clear that this was to be no picnic.
Yeah. Oh,
say me, Mr. and I referred only to Magenta and myself. I'm sorry if you found my words misleading. You see, you are to remain here. In spirit, anyway.
Quite devastating, Elisa!
Yes, Dr. Scott. A laser capable of emitting a beam of pure antimatter.
You mean you're gonna kill him? What was his crime?
Oh, Grant.
You saw what happened to any society must be protected!
Exactly, Dr. Scott. Now, Frankenfurter, your time has come. Say goodbye to all of this, and hello to Oblivion.
Hello, Oblivion.
Do your worst.
Thank you.
and crawling on the planet space. Some insects called the human race. Lost in time, lost in space, and